know stressing about money is something a lot of us have in common, especially if your finances have been affected by this current pandemic. So to help make sure you come out of this sitting pretty in the green, let's see where we can tweak the budget.
Wrap it!
Here we go, our finances out is our girl, Tiffany, the Budgetnista Aliche. Welcome back to the show.
Hi, Tiffany.
Hi.
Hi, how are you?
We've been all our lives.
Yes, hi.
So, Tiffany, this is a time when a lot of people are trying to do all types of division, multiplication, calculus to make sure they're able to pay the bills and at least put food on the table. So when it comes to finances, what's one of the first things our real fam should do in this stressful time?
So what I say first things first is to create your noodle budget. So sometimes you got to drop down and get your noodle on, girl, right? So your noodle budget is your essential baseline budget. Like, what are just the essential expenses? So I want you to think to yourself two questions. Do I need this expense to be healthy? Do I need this expense to be safe? And if you do, then it belongs on your noodle budget. But I want you to first also calculate what your normal budget is so you know the difference. So your normal budget includes your rent, your mortgage, utilities, but also maybe going out, grooming, entertainment. And maybe let's just say that's $3,000 a month. But your noodle budget would be similar, but without the bells and whistles. It would just be the rent, the utilities, no entertainment, no going out. And when you know what your noodle budget is, you can drop down to it if you need it. And sometimes we have to be even more extreme. I remember 10 years ago during the last recession, I lost my job and I ended up having to move back home just so I could take the mortgage component off of my noodle budget. So if you have to do something extreme, sometimes some bills are not going to get paid. That's okay too.
Wait, teach me, Tiffany, why is it a noodle budget?
Well, I call it a noodle budget because if you had to eat ramen noodles, remember them days? If you had to get down to the get down, sometimes you got to drop down and get your noodle on.
Got it. That's a good question, Tiffany. Okay, so now that we've got our budget, what do we do next?
Save, save, save. So savings is the best thing you can do during times like these. Ideally, you want to have 6 months of your essential expenses saved. So 6 months of your noodle budget saved. Equally as important, how much you have saved as to where you should save it. And I say you should be saving it in an online only bank account. And here's why. One, and only banks pay you higher interest because they don't have the same overhead as your regular bank. And two, it makes your money inconvenient because you keep your savings here in an online-only bank account and you keep your regular spending money at your checking account at your regular bank. And that transfer from savings to checking takes typically about 24, sometimes up to 72 hours. So it means no more impulse buying. But also, people always ask, Budgetnista, where should I find this online-only bank? How do I pick out one? And you're going to go to this website called magnifymoney.com, and you're going to look for four things. One, you're going to look for a bank that has an A grade, because don't nobody want a C bank, right?
No.
Two, you're going to look for a bank that's FDIC insured. That means you'll get your money back should that bank close down, up to $250,000 per bank account. Three, you're going to look for a bank that pays out the highest interest rate. Get your coins, right? And four, you're going to look for a bank that has the lowest deposit requirement, meaning that you can open up this bank account for like a dollar. And also, some banks have a balance requirement in order to continue to earn that interest rate. So you want to look for maybe like a dollar is all you have to keep in there in order to earn that interest rate. As you do that, you'll be good.
Wow.
All right. Tiffany, we just love your information. What about them credit card bills, though, girl? How do we handle that? Because you know they want their money.
Yes, they do. But I want you to be about your business and want your money, especially during a recession. So normally I'm someone who's like, get rid of those credit card bills. They're expensive because credit cards typically charge double-digit interest rates, but not during a recession. During a recession, cash is queen. Hold on to your savings. Mm-hmm. If you don't have 6 months of a noodle budget save, what I really want you to do is I want you to pay the minimum to your credit cards and pay the extra to your online only savings account. And when you get to 6 months of expenses saved, then you can go back and be a little bit more aggressive towards your debt, because we forget that debt free and no savings equals debt. I'm going to show you what I mean. So let's just say you're like, woo, I'm debt free, but I don't have any savings. Oh no, my car breaks. right? Car breaks down, you look at your savings account, there's no money there. What are you going to do? You're going to swipe your card and get right back into debt, and they're going to charge you interest for using that. So focus on savings during times like this.
I love that. So much great information. Is there any way to get bills like water, gas, electricity reduced during this time?
Yes, you want to be on your destiny's child. Can you pay my bills? Can you? So yes, absolutely. You are going to reach out to your service provider. So that's your landlord. That's your mortgage person. That's your insurance person. That's anybody that you pay a bill to. And you're going to share that you are experiencing financial hardship, because many of them have a financial hardship program. And what that means is they can actually defer or furlough your bills. It can actually, they can bring your interest rate down or forgive your interest rate for a period of time. But you want to make sure that you know what's the real cost of this help. So you want to ask, so when do I have to pay that back? Do I have to pay that back? For example, some private banks were telling folks who had mortgages with them, you don't have to worry about your mortgage for 3 whole months. Don't worry about it. But what they weren't saying up front is that 90 days later, that full 3-month payment was going to come due. So you want to make sure that as you're asking for help, you're also making sure you know how much that help is going to cost you in the long run. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Yep. That help ain't free. Plan, Tiffany. Mm-hmm. Thank you so much for coming back and educating us on our real fam today. You're a savior. And I hope everybody out there took notes, because these are some things that you can start doing right now.